Hey guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episode 22 of Undead Unlocks. Let's go ahead and get started in 3, 2, 1, go. By look how soft he looks. I mean, damn, we could knock his ass out. I mean, that's a little too much. I mean, damn, Victor. Well, where else is she supposed to go? Behind you. True. Back home. Is that you? Fogo, I wouldn't even. Oh my God. Oh, thank God. Oh, But she's just trying to find out the truth. I mean, is that really a good reason to kill her? Because, non-extent, trespasser, yeah, no! Mm-hmm. They should be dead because of that. Like, God, that looks so cool. In a weird way. This is gonna be really bad. Like, no, he meant to do that. the fact that he hesitated too, oof.
Oh. Ooh.
Honestly, anybody would be dead with that impact right there. I'm just saying, but you know. Hershey Kanisa. We have questions. I mean, and you know, and it might be dangerous, but you know, it's a chance we're willing to take. Yeah, you two are close. No, I think more the way that you act in certain things, not. But you care about her, though. Right? Like. Well, that's messed up. Like, that still could have been somewhat useful for her. I'm thinking the 1865 moment in April would have been an important moment, but because of the fact is, she got something else. Victor's like, no, that's not important anymore. What? Okay. Okay. I'll get you there. All right. Okay. Okay, we got 2 weeks left with this show. The thing is now is they're going back to feeding Autumn. That's it. But how in the world are they gonna wrap this up in 2 weeks? Like, I really have no freaking clue. But it was really nice for these last two episodes to go into Andy's memories slash Victor's memories at the same time. Also to know the truth that yes, Victor and Juiz had feelings for each other and are in a relationship, and that he doesn't want to see her suffer, so it's just like, okay, he just wants to straight up kill her, which is messed up, but I get it. Like, you never want to see the person that you care about so much suffering. Nobody wants that. So you have to do what you think is best, not only for you, but also for that person, So it's a double-edged sword regardless with anything. Is it weird that I feel like next week might be like a recap episode or something? One of these two have to be because, like, and I could be wrong. Like, dead ass, we could just get something else. It's still main story focus based and everything. But I feel like because we are so close and we might get a quote unquote potential season two, then yeah, I can definitely see them doing something for it. But I don't know. I mean, it's just with 2 weeks left, once again, there's a lot of unanswered questions and how this is going to end, per se. But no, I really enjoyed the fact that she got to literally learn more about Andy. That was the biggest thing that I really wanted going into the beginning of this because, Fuko is just our main character. We're supposed to know almost like everything about her by the time we're like halfway through, but still learning new things about her at every single time. But because of the fact is, it's both her and Andy, and it's like, well, we know this much about Babe, so when are we getting something about Andy? But having episodes literally about his past, like, it's really sad because damn, like, you feel bad for him so much because it's like he's a walking death magnet. Like, everyone around him that he cares about dies. Fuko is the only one who hasn't as of now. Fuko and what difference? But who knows? That could change. Don't do that though. I don't want her to die. I'm just saying. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction towards episode 22 of Undead Unluck. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all next Friday for episode 23. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.